First, to get something on screen, even if it's not the latest data, we'll pull data from the cache. Like service workers themselves, getting data from the cache object is a progressive enhancement, so we need to check if the cache's object is available in the global scope. If it is, we'll read the cached weather data from there and get something on screen as quickly as possible. Next, it's time to get the weather data from the API with an AJAX request. If you're feeling adventurous, try using the new Fetch API. But remember, you'll probably need to polyfill it so that it works in all browsers. When the getForecast method fires, it now makes two asynchronous requests. One that will try and get data from the cache, and one that will try and make an AJAX request. If there's data in the cache, it will be returned extremely quickly, usually within tens of milliseconds. Then, when the AJAX request responds, the card will be updated with the freshest data direct from our weather API. Perfect. Well, okay, not quite. There is a potential race condition. What happens if the network responds before the cache? When that happens, the latest data from the network could be clobbered by the older cache data. For a weather app, that's probably not a critical problem. You might be caught without an umbrella, or you'll wear shorts on a cold day. But what about time-sensitive data, like stock prices, or a spreadsheet with financial data? In this case, it's important to have a flag indicating that there is a network request pending, and only use the cache data if the network request is still pending. That ensures that if the XHR responds faster than the cache, the flag will prevent the cache from overwriting the latest data from the network.